Hello. My name is Yannis Emiris. I will give you a short overview of the personnel in Pythagoras, and then I will go into the technical aspects, which are closer to my interests. So let me start with introducing the members a bit more closely. You've heard Alexis Anastasiou, so he's the founder and CEO. He's an engineer by profession, and he's very enthusiastic about the new technologies, so he's leading the vision. He has a lot of experience with smaller and larger companies, and he has worked also with startups. So you've already met him during the talk. I am working on the scientific aspects and the technical aspects that I'll detail right after this introduction. I've been working computer science for 25 years. You have my CV here, you have my full CV. I come from scientific computing. I do a lot of data science today, machine learning, and I will have the opportunity to mention some of the research that we're trying to bring into Pythagoras. I won't spend so much time as my colleagues earlier, but I think you get the idea is that we are trying to bring in very innovative and disruptive technologies into real products. Okay, so you'll hear my view. You've already heard some other colleagues in the area. Jason Theodorakopoulos is sitting right there. He's leading the development. You'll see some of the work that we have already done, and most of it comes from Jason. He has been heavily involved in Meteorologica, which is one of our projects that I'll mention later. He's an expert in software engineering and data engineering. So he's very useful. I encourage you to talk to him during the break. Manolis Christoforou will talk later. He's sitting right there. Very courageous guy, decided to do a PhD with me on machine learning. He already has some amazing clustering algorithms, and he's starting to work for Pythagoras as of very recently. Dimitra Panu also will speak right after me, sitting right there. She has experience in some very specialized techniques that are applied to bioinformatics, and we hope to be able to transfer them into our problems. Machine learning is the area of her master's thesis. So let me go into the current projects that we are developing. Vespucci, of course, is the main talk of today's meeting, so I will not spend so much time myself. You'll have a whole talk dedicated to Vespucci right after myself. You've already heard it's going to be an evaluator of cryptocurrencies, where we hope to leverage on machine learning and also dig into the blockchains that are underlying the different cryptocurrencies. So there's a lot of technical aspects in Vespucci that go beyond the state of the art. I will not give you much details. VTX is already mentioned. We are not alone on that, but we are contributing heavily because we are part of the ecosystem. And I will mention how we ourselves use VTX tokens for our own products. Okay, so VTX, it comes from Volentix, but we are heavily involved. Again, not spending so much time here. Let me go to our proper work. First example is ParkLink. So ParkLink is a distributed application that helps you park. Athens is not the only city where parking can be a heavy duty. I mentioned here, of course, that all the motivation, both for the driver and for the community, pollution, costs, and so on. I have some numbers that show the size of the market. So both in terms of parking, the market of parking, revenue, people affected, city population, number of cars. So these are numbers that show that parking is a problem, but also will be a big problem in the future. So this is one of the projects that is already running. You can go to this web page and find the prototype. So there is a prototype software running already. What does it do? It lets people declare spots and allows also users to use them. So it has it has the possibility to add spots, like in this example, and also connected to Google Maps, it will let the driver go to the specific spot. So parking spots can be on street or off street. We use a blockchain mainly because it's the default distributed technology. So it's a powerful distributed technology for us, for the company, and it's also somehow the default decentralized tool. Okay, it might not be very sensitive information in this example, but we still like to use it as a distributed tool. And what is also interesting here is the smart contracts that we use to pay spotters. So it's a tangible incentive for people to declare and to add spots in the system. Second project is Done. So Done is connecting people that have errands, that have tasks, with people that are willing to do them for revenue. Okay, so here I call them needers and doers. Needers are people that have tasks to be accomplished. Doers are those that are willing to take on a task for pay. Okay, so it's a platform that allows peer-to-peer communication on simple tasks, and it, in addition to that, it tries to optimize efficiency and skill allocation. Okay, of course. So I see it in two layers. One is just bringing people together so that needs will be covered and people can cover the needs for pay. And at the second level is the optimization level. So again, smart contracts are very important here, because at the end of the matching process, there will be a smart contract between the needer and the doer, okay, after the matching is accomplished. Decentralization, of course, is very important in this application. It's the main idea besides such an application, that we're able to do large-scale decentralized allocation and matching. And our last project that I have right here is DeMeteorologica. So it was mentioned, Meteorologica was mentioned. It's a project that has to do with weather forecasting. So we have a lot of in-house expertise in that. We are trying to leverage machine learning for modeling large domains, let's say the atmosphere, at a low resolution, and be able to have very fast and accurate predictions. So this is Meteorologica. It's already part of a Horizon 2020 proposal headed by Professor Gunopoulos. And it also relies on a special relationship with Terna. So Terna is the leader wind energy provider in Greece. They provide us with data because they have sensors on their mills, on their windmills. And they also want they are heavy users of any kind of weather prediction, basically wind prediction, that we can offer. The difference between Terna is not the hardest customer for us in the sense that they are kind of local needs, right? They want to know what happens near their parks. We take it one step further, and we're able to model large domains. So this example is the Swiss Alps. Actually, the photo ranges from the French Riviera to Switzerland, almost to the Austrian border. And this is a convection prediction. So this is more or less Meteorologica, what I have described so far. The D in Meteorologica is the next step, where we wish to use decentralized computing, once again, in order to be able to increase the computing power available for this task. So this is a common paradigm today. You allow people to collaborate. Users contribute their computing power, and then they are able to solve a bigger task. So here I have an example. I say, how about if 100 users in Greece were willing to collaborate on this task? Then you would have a computing power 100-fold higher. What can you give them in return? You give them the prediction. So people that contribute to this networking effort, they get the prediction for free. People can get the prediction even if they are not contributors, So non-contributors, they have to buy this kind of prediction with our own token. So DWX is the token of the specific project. Okay. So so this is an idea that borrows on the existing work of Meteorologica, which was already, as I said, it's already in line, especially with Terna. And there are already very good results predicting winds and the atmosphere. And on top of that, we are building the distributed application, okay, the decentralized application. Okay, so these are the specific projects that we are dealing with right now. As I said, you'll hear more about Vespucci right after my talk, which is, of course, our main focus so far. I will conclude my talk with my favorite slide. Hope it's not very technical. This is the technologies we're trying to bring in, either from my own team, some more of my students are here, or from teams like Dimitri Gunopoulos, who is in two doors down the hall, or Minos Garoufalakis, you've already heard. So what are we using? We are using deep networks. Deep neural networks is a big hype today. This is the first deep neural network, 2012. It's called AlexNet. It's the one that beat all the other learning methods in image recognition. So they managed to build kernel-based methods, PCA approaches, and so far. That's somehow a turning point that turned the vision community into deep neural networks. And since then, of course, many more things are being done. So decision-making, actually, is a crucial operation that neural networks are able to tackle today. And we are heavily investing on that. Big data, of course, data science is something that we've been doing for some time. So here I have an example of tackling, of course, it's small dimension, but the idea is how you tackle the curse of dimensionality. Your data is complex, very big. So when I talked about Meteorologica, the goal is that we are able to model a large domain, continent scale even, Europe, at a grid of size 100 meters. Data is huge. It's big data also in the sense that it flows very fast into your system. One approach that we have championed, and we see that it works in practice, is randomized projections, dimensionality reduction. So you take your data that is in very high dimension, and you project it into different ways. This is what I try to draw here. And of course, our latest, our last technology, and probably the most recent, is distributed computing. Today is called decentralized computing based on blockchains. So this is an example of blockchain where blocks are added, you keep the longest chain. There are some technical details, I will not go into that, but these are tools that we are all using together to achieve our results. So thank you for your attention.
We will present today Vespucci, our Vespucci project. It's a feature of a Volentix wallet, or a subsystem, you can say. Now, what is Vespucci? It's a ranking platform, an analytics and ranking platform for cryptocurrencies. Why does Vespucci stand out? Here are some competitive advantages. First of all, it's an investor guide. You can say, okay, investor guides is a common feature. There are so many tools that have it. What makes us, what differentiates us from other tools is the combination of all these features together and makes us a powerful product. So, first of all, fundamental and technological data and analysis for cryptocurrencies. And that's why we use broad spectrum of sources, GitHub, Twitter, Facebook, Reddit, Telegram, or for technological and the fundamental analysis, we use lots of parameters like the age of a coin, the number of transactions, how the team works, publicity, and the media. And lots of parameters. Another advantage is the transparency methodology. We have open sources, so can be accessed and extended by developers. Another one advantage of us is our research. We use state-of-the-art techniques in order to build a more efficient product. And some others are that our platform is easily extendable and scalable. That means that we will provide APIs in order to be accessed by developers and interact with our platform. Blockchain evaluation of the blockchain technology evaluation, and also some fundamental and technological data from analysts. What does that mean? We will provide parameters that we cannot evaluate, that can be not evaluated by machine learning techniques, such as white papers, teamwork, team members. It's difficult to evaluate them, so we do this by cooperating with expert analysts. And last but not least is our security. We provide reliability for our users. What does that mean? We have lots of sources. We have lots of evaluated methods we use in order to prevent the users to make mistakes for investment. So our features is what we are. We are an analytical agent that uses AI technology and deep learning techniques in order to build a rating system for cryptocurrencies. Here is our rating system. For our sources, we separate our system to three subsystems: the sentiment, technical, and fundamental technological. In the first system, the sentiment, we do text mining in different social media sources like Facebook, Twitter, Telegram, Reddit, and some on blog posts. We evaluate the sentiment score, and we provide this, we feed it to our neural net. On the technical part, we use charts and values for 1 year, don't know, maybe more, in order to provide a basic model, a basic prediction for the next price. And for the fundamental technological analysis, we use a variety of parameters, like fundamental data, like blockchain characteristics, GitHub activity, GitHub stars, team activity, news, references on articles, and others. So we have these three subsystems, and if we combine these together in a neural net, we can provide a ranking system, a ranking score. Now Manolis will continue the presentation.
To sum up all that information given by Dimitra, we can see here the overview of the Vespucci. This is the pipeline we follow to combine all this data. And starting from our pillars, which is the fundamental and technological analysis, the sentiment analysis, and the technical analysis, we collect data in order to train our neural networks. And after training our neural networks, we provide the final ranking of each coin in order to see how this correlates with the increase of the coin market, or the market value of the coin. So also to be always accurate and up to date and more efficient, we also collect collect continuously data from those pillars to retrain our model at some time steps. More specific for the sentiment analysis, starting from collecting data from Facebook, Twitter, Telegram, and Reddit, we rate its post or tweet that might be related for a coin using a sentiment score, which shows how happy or unhappy a user can be with a coin this time, at the time. Using these sentiment scores, we train our neural network to see how this correlates with the market cap value of the coin itself. So maybe when a user have good ratings about the coin, we can see that the coin market value of the coin increases. Similarly, for the fundamental technological analysis, starting from our features, we using a scoring function, we rate our data in order to select the more important ones, and again we train our neural network to find how these features are correlated with the increase and decrease of the coin market cap value of each coin. All this result to the tool we want to provide, the Vespucci. Here we can see the user experience in Vespucci. What we want to have is to provide an interface that can be easily readable by non-experts, but also to provide as more features as can for expert users. So we can see that the user can view all the coins or select a subset of them, having some filters or selections he wants. And we can see here that we have a ranking for all the coins due to their market cap value, and also our Vespucci score, which is shown by stars next to each coin. Furthermore, the user can also see more information for each coin. Here we can see, for example, for the Ethereum, the page where we have a briefly overview of the coin, our Vespucci score, of course, and some other meaningful visualizations for sentiment analysis, transactions, the GitHub activity, the market cap value, etc. Our current goal, right now we have a social media listener, which is the tool that collects the data from Facebook, Twitter, Reddit. And using these data sets and text analytics, the sentiment analysis previously mentioned, we extract some scores for each coin. What we're working on now is the neural networks, and our aim is to have a minimum viable product by the end of the summer. So now, Dimitra will present you a demo of Vespucci.
Here we can see our first demo. There is a list of coins. We can select one, for example, we can select the Digibyte. And we see clearly the correlation of, here is the sentiment score, the average sentiment score. And here is the price in US dollars. So we see the correlation of the sentiment analysis with a price trend. And here is the signal. We see the map for which has colored the where we took the sentiment score, where we took the tweets. And here is the distribution of the positive sign and the negative. And we did the tweet analysis.
So what we basically want to do is to have a 360 view of the true value of each coin. Our future work is, of course, to identify the parameters for technical analysis, use deep learning neural networks to combine the knowledge from each analysis layer, and also to provide the total ranking from each layer, but also and also a separate one. For the technical analysis, the sentiment analysis, and the fundamental and technological analysis. Also to add more sources for our sentiment analysis and technical analysis. This is needed because social media vary over the time or due to the trend or anything. Also to combine the knowledge from experts analysts as an additional parameter. What we also would like to do is to look into the blockchains to understand and use it as parameters for the fundamental technological analysis. And finally, of course, to interact with the Volentix wallet in order to use information from transactions as source for our fundamental technological analysis, and to provide the user with meaningful information using our Vespucci score we have.